Ah, Bishan-AMK Park, filled with tall, majestic trees, everlasting flowing river, melodious calls of birds, and alien species! Alien species! Lama taking a walk!
Hello, MJ.
Oh, hello, hello, sorry, I got carried away. Hi, today, we will be talking about how mercy release can potentially do more harm than good, and we are happy to have Thekchen Choling's Singha Rinpoche to join us on this alien wildlife treasure hunt.
I've been a Lama for almost 30 years. Throughout all this time, I have witnessed many, many different groups of people who are doing animal liberation or mercy relief.
So many people, right, when they engage in such behaviours, they have good intentions, but they don't look at the bigger picture of how harmful it can be in many aspects. So in fact, most of the animals that are released, they are actually bred in farms and sold in pet shops, so they are not captured from the wild. Shufu! See, that's the shell of the golden apple snail, and they are quite invasive because they actually drive some of our local native snail species into extinction. So like our green tree snail, our local apple snails, which we can hardly see anymore nowadays. It's circle like a good symbol. If I stand in the middle, then the longer I stand, the more good luck I'll get.
Good luck or not good luck all depends in your heart and your mind.
So that time right when we came here, there's actually red claw crayfish, you know, the xiaolongxia, the
yes, yes.
Yes! So there were a lot here actually, and the kids were catching it, but they were hiding beneath lah.
Right.
Oh, so many burrows, okay, no wonder. A lot of times, people don't realise that the animal they release are not suitable for certain habitats. For example, there was this recent news of somebody releasing freshwater bullfrogs into the mangroves of Pasir Ris Park. And sadly, the bullfrogs ended up being predated on or dying because of the brackish water environment. Every animal is adapted to live in a specific environment. For example, freshwater animals that are adapted to the freshwater environment have somewhat low concentrations of salt in their bodies that is similar to the freshwater environment. When you put them in seawater, the surrounding water has much more salt concentration. So water will flow out the freshwater animals via osmosis naturally, and the animals will eventually die due to dehydration. Even if the animals seem to be doing alright, because they are not used to hunting and finding shelter in the wild, chances are that they won't be able to survive for long either way. It's just like how if I release my little princess QWERTY into the forest, she will not last for a day, I promise you, because she can't even kill a cockroach in her house. How can she pounce on a rat and like find food? Nah, she needs her mama.
As a llama, do you have to be vegan or something?
Do I have to be vegan?
Yeah.
It's more important to be vegan in your heart and soul than to be vegan in your mouth.
It's all about the spirit and the mind, the heart and the soul. It's nothing physical. Actually, I don't know if I said. I don't know.
You anyhow bomb, ah.
Sorry. That's the Java miner. Yeah, that's the one that's invasive. It's everywhere in Singapore.
Right.
So they actually push out the common miner. So common miner is the one that is native to Singapore. So this is the Java, the introduced one.
You know what plant is this?
Oh, I have no idea. Yeah.
This is the plant that the Egyptians used to make paper 5,000 years ago.
Papyrus?
Yes.
Oh my god, really? Please don't come and harvest to make paper, okay? Look, we can see here first, then we go there. Okay. So, Sifu, here is where everyone will stop and look down at the beautiful fishes. But the thing is, most of the fish here, they are probably alien species. So they are mainly tilapias and cichlids, different cichlids. You can see at the bottom, right, they have this circular thing.
Right.
So that's actually when they are going to breed or they're going to build a nest. We actually saw, right, in a Windsor Park, we saw a luan in the pond.
In the past, maybe 25 years ago, everybody was crazy about luan yu. And then after that, you know, the luan fish will have 4D number and this and that. If they buy the fish, they spend lots of money and the fish didn't bless them with good luck and 4D or lottery. You know, then what they do, they just throw the fish away. And so that's what happens. Many people very blindly chase after good luck, not knowing that good luck comes from the heart of gratitude. If you have gratitude and you cherish what you have, you will always be blessed with good luck.
Let's say these introduced species are able to survive and adapt to the new environment. What happens is that they may outcompete with our own native species for resources such as food, shelter, or even through direct predation. And if there's not enough predators to control the introduced species, their populations will kaboom, explode. And what happens is that this will not only disrupt the natural balance of our ecosystem, it may drive some of our own native species into extinction. And that's also when they will attain the ultimate label of being an invasive alien species. Ayas!
So MJ, actually, the whole idea of mercy relief or animal liberation is to save the animal from being killed. So for example, in the past, people will be killing goats at the roadside. And then they'll be selling the meat fresh. So what you do is that you want to buy the animal and save the animal and let the animal go free, right? So that's the whole idea. But these days, if you think about animal liberation, let's say you want to liberate the pigs or the chickens from the abattoir, and then you just release the chickens every day, I think this whole park here will be filled with pigs and chickens. The best way to save the environment is to eat less meat or try not to eat meat. But this is all personal choice.
It's the red yard slider or the red yard terrapins, and wow, we see them a lot in pet stores, and it's still very common nowadays. You know, you see the small ones, but what people don't know is they can actually grow to quite a big size, and when that happens, a lot of them like to release them into our reservoirs and ponds. So, Shifu, what do you suggest that we can do, you know, since Visak Day is coming?
There is this Grow a Coral and Seed a Reef program. It is a perfect opportunity for us to support something that is forgotten, that is the corals and the sea. And also in the past years, we have been promoting and telling people to adopt stray animals and other animal welfare groups where other people who give up their pets, they need another forever home. So if you can, please do that.
Ecosystems are built over many, many, many years with a stable balance of prey and predators that are interdependent on each other. Basically, there's a certain yin and yang in natural ecosystems that is delicately balanced. But when we release non-native species randomly into our ecosystem, well, that's not very natural, so it will disrupt the balance and usually something will lose out, be it the introduced species itself or our very own native species. In worst case scenarios, the entire ecosystem actually fall apart like a domino. So we've actually seen that happen before, like the Great Lakes in North America, where invasive species are actually released into the lakes and it has driven some of the native species into extinction.
Please be responsible for your own pets. Be responsible for your own diet. We should all take control of what we put in our mouths, and what we buy, and what we release, so that we can make our place a better place for all.
That's all for today, and I hope all of us are more aware of certain impacts of certain actions that we see happening around us. Just keep thinking!
I forgot to say!
It's okay.